Hey, this is Peter from Nexton Web. In this video, I will show you the styling options of the layers. Here's a slide which has a background image, a purple-blue horizontal gradient, and the content of the slide is centered. I will show you two different examples with the same content but different style. So on each slide, you can see the same two headings and a button. On this slide, the background has a solid color, not an image, and the text is left aligned. The text is centered again, but the image does not have any overlay. To increase the legibility of the text, there's a white box behind it. It's also important to keep in mind that your slider not only needs to look good, its style needs to fit your whole website. The slider on the left looks very good on its own, but it does not fit into the design of the page. The slider on the right has the same font family and matching colors, so it fits perfectly. This is why it matters how you design your slider. If you choose Smart Slider as your slider plugin, you'll be able to create any great-looking designs. The styling process is simple, and more importantly, completely visual. You can find the design options of the layers at the Style tab of the layer window. Changing the font family can be important to make sure the design of your slider matches your sites. Use the drop-down list to select a predefined font or type in the name of your own font. I don't want this text to be bold, so I will change the font weight. Every Smart Slider 3 layer has its own styling options. Call to action buttons should catch the visitor's attention, so it's important to design them well. Need more styling options? Hit the More button to reveal features like letter spacing or text transform. Use the Less button to hide them again. Usually buttons have a different background color on mouse over. You can edit the hover state by selecting it at the drop-down list next to the labels. To edit the text styling on mouse over, switch to hover next to the typography. At the other labels, like the background, you can also find a drop-down list where you can select which state you want to edit. I want a different background color on hover. Here you can set the opacity of the color, but now I will pick a color without opacity. You can see the result in the canvas as well. Just move your mouse over the button. If you don't like the changes you made for the hover state, you can reset to the normal state anytime. Let's see some other styling options. You can create rounded corners with the border radius option. I need more space around my text, so I increase the padding. You can set the padding value in pixels, percent, or em. We recommend using the EM value to achieve the best responsive layout. To speed up the designing process, you can save your styles at each layer for later use. We created a bunch of presets you can choose from to help you get started with the nice-looking design. I will save the style of my button, so I can use it later. I can load this preset anytime from now on. At some special layers, you can find other styling options than normal or hover. Use the drop-down list next to the typography to choose from the available styling states. For example, at the highlighted heading layer, you can set another color to the highlighted text. If you don't like the changes you made, you can reset to normal. At the image box layer, you can style the heading and description individually. We predefined some Google fonts you can choose from at the font family. But if you prefer, you can use your own font instead. To be able to use custom fonts, first make sure that your page loads the font. If it doesn't load it already, then you'll need to write a few lines of CSS. You can copy the sample code from our documentation, which is linked in the description of the video. I have already made my site load this code by putting it to the CSS file of my child theme. I've also adjusted the name of the font and the path where the font file is located. Now I'll type my custom font name in the font family field. But this font doesn't look like the font that I wanted. Let's see how this looks in the front end. As you can see, the custom font loaded fine on the front end, The reason the font works on the front end is that it's loaded by my Chai theme. However, the Chai theme isn't loading in the backend. That's why the font doesn't work in the editor. To be able to see the font in the slide editor, we need to load it there. Go to the global settings where I am now. Find the editor additional CSS files field and write the URL of the CSS file where you load your own font. Now the font loads in the slide editor as well. That's all you need to know about the styling options. If you have not subscribed to our channel yet, make sure to click on the subscribe button. See you in the next video.